I'd like to talk to you about the work of Stephen Oppenheimer, who in 2003 worked on the maternal mitochondrial DNA in an effort to establish who are we as a people, the Homo sapien. His story begins somewhere in 150,000 years ago, but I prefer to start the story about 85,000 years ago when a group of individuals left Africa and walked along the coastal areas, Sindh, Iran, Sindh, in the triangular part of India, all the way to Sumatra, all the way to Taiwan. So Stephen Oppenheimer states that all the non-African people of the world are related to this group of people who left Africa. Two questions. What was the migration model and why did they not head westwards? Why did they come eastwards? The migration model was never one of people saying, hey, let's walk all the way to Australia. It was never one of those things. Rather, the situation was that a group of people living in a place, if after maybe living there for a few years, they have the water is polluted or the resources have run dry or some issues are there, the whole family just goes 1 kilometer down the road and starts a new life. So it's a generation by generation movement. It never was a continuous focused walking, walking, walking till they find some place. Generation by generation migration. The best model we have is the Bushman society. Bushmen do not have possessions. Today, if we are all tied to the land because you have a house or a flat or land or something, you have a car, your kids go to school somewhere. So we can't uproot ourselves and go to another place. We are tied over here. But ancient society, they had nothing. They could easily move from one place to another, no biggie at all. They could easily do things like that. So this is the model. Why did they not head westwards? Well, in the time frame under question, there was one more species of human living in Europe as well as up to Iran, up to Chagai Hills. And this species is called Neanderthals. Today, the Homo sapien, after generations of good nutrition, we are about 6 feet tall, about 70 kilograms, and those kinds of things. But the early Homo sapien was maybe about 4.5 feet tall, and maybe about 40 kilograms, 50 kilograms. He did not want to confront the more bigger Neanderthal. So they hid along the beach, and they walked in this path. And Stephen Oppenheimer provides some archaeological evidence also to support such an assertion. 74,000 years ago, there was a super volcano in Sumatra. This is called the Mount Toba Event. It caused a 6-year nuclear winter and an instant 1,000-year ice age with a dramatic population crash to less than 10,000 breeding individuals. Volcanic ash from this eruption covered India and Pakistan by up to 5 meters. If you can imagine, 5 meters of ash all over India and Pakistan had extincted the human race. This picture over here shows you an excavation in Jwalapuram in Andhra Pradesh, where even today they find the ash layer. And here's the most exciting piece of news. Under the ash layer, they find human artifacts, showing that humans had lived before the Toba event. And then you find the ash layer and you find later artifacts and so on. The researcher who works in that is Ravi Kurisetar. He's the one who works in this work. So 65,000 years or so, the ice ages had ended and the warming of Western Europe took place. And that warming coincided with the extinction of the Neanderthal. They just disappeared from the fossil record. You don't find them. You don't find them anymore. And we don't know whether they died by disease or war or what happened. But they left a vacuum. And that vacuum was filled in by the Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens from this part of the world, approximately Sindh and Gujarat, they're the ones who apparently left and crossed the Bosphorus and moved on and became the future Europeans. Approximately 40,000 years ago, groups of people from this part of India, from Sumeria, from eastern part of India, and from other regions, they joined in Siberia and crossed the land bridge at that time, the Bering Strait, to North and South America and became the future Native Americans. So this is the story of the ancient human migration according to the maternal mitochondrial DNA as laid out in a very early time frame, 2003, by Stephen Oppenheimer.